just says it all. It's just, you know.
What came first, the Sergio Flores or the Sexy Sax Man?
I'm not sure what you mean.
If you had to choose one thing, being sexy or playing sax, what would you choose?
Anyone can be sexy.
What was the first song you learned to play on saxophone? What was the second song you learned on saxophone? Do you think people are drawn to you because of your incredible sexiness or more because of your saxiness?
I think it's a combination.
Do you swim?
I have an underwater saxophone and I bring it with me sometimes. Helps me build the lungs, you know, because you gotta have some power if you wanna. I like to do the butterfly and the freestyle, and then last I do the froggy stroke is what I call it.
Did your parents name you saxophone superstar Sergio Flores?
They named me Sergio Alejandro Flores Reveles. That's my birth name.
And Sexy Sax Man came from an uncle, or?
I don't know how that came about. I don't know. There's a period of my life that I got some blank spots. There's, for some reason, some sort of amnesia going on for 5-10 years of my life. So I don't know how that all came about.
And when you came out of it, you were Sexy Sax Man. If you could play for the president, what song would you play for the president?
It's powerful.
That's probably what I admire most about you, is it's like, you know what you like. If you could give a message to your fans, either through saxophone or through words, what would it be? And please take the chance to do so. People say that Sexy Sax Man is bigger than George Michael. How does that make you feel?
These questions are weird to me. I don't know why you word them that way. I don't understand.
If you could play one song for George Michael, what would it be? Thank you so much.
Thank you guys. Thanks for having me. I want to play a little something for you guys before I go.